Very nice. I mean, it was nice to see that we were, you know, working counts, getting in hitting counts, and be able to put the ball in play and put a ball in play hard, and be able to score runs and make a comeback.
And then, how would you judge the homestand overall, and the just being able to play at home for the first time of the 2014 season?
Well, it was nice to come home because people don't realize we get a lot of work done. We get to do our fundamentals before games and get some individual defensive work and get extra hitting in. So it's nice to be home and you know, be able to control our time a little bit better instead of everybody else. But you know, it was nice because I saw a lot of improvement. The guys doing, you know, taking better approaches at the plate. You know, our defense has been solid. You know, it's nice to be at home, especially here with the fans that we've got.
A lot of fly balls going out there in left field. How much do you think the wind played a factor in that?
Well, you know, we don't measure the game by the wind. It's mere the fact that we didn't command the zone very well. And every home run they hit, we were down in the count. And we got, you know, our theory is we get ahead in the count and go from there. You know, we didn't command the zone much at all today. And in essence, when the wind's blowing out and you're not throwing strikes and we're getting ahead, you know, that things like that will happen. And, you know, we had 8 walks today, and, you know, you can't win many ball games with 8 walks. It's, you know, we pride ourselves in being able to command the zone. And when you get 8 walks, it's a lot of free bases. And with the wind blowing out, it just can really turn into a multi-run game.
Some nice resiliency shown by the team, though, getting back in it and climbing back and tying it up there late in the game. How proud of you are them for that? And I guess, is there a learning experience in that?
Oh, there's most definitely is. I mean, the ability to be able to battle and realize the game isn't over. And, you know, there's a lot of people who thought that, you know, they're bombs away hitting. I think they scored, you know, most of their runs on home runs before that. And, you know, we were able to stay focused and push things and then maximize on opportunities and got right back in the game.
What are you looking for now going on the road in the next 2 road series, and then the next one's going to be against the division leader in Dayton?
Well, we're going to look at, you know, continuing our success at the plate and making sure that we understand who we are at the plate, and I think it's starting to go in that direction. Pitching-wise, you know, it was one of those days today, but it's been very solid. The pitching has been solid, and, you know, it was unusual today, but I see a lot of good things happening. Now we're going to take our show and see what we can do to other, you know, people and, you know, get after it. I'm looking forward to it, and I'd see a lot of improvement, and that's what we have to do.
Yeah, it seems like pitching is the thing that's really been so strong for you guys to start the season, and then hitting comes on today. How do you get both of those things to kind of go into sync at the same time? Do you do anything from a managerial standpoint?
No, you know, you just put the right lineup in, and, you know, the main thing is consistency in the message that we put out. We've got to be consistent. There can't be any sense of confusion. We're not going to put any pressure on the offense or put any pressure on anybody. We go out and do our job and prepare the right way and, you know, go out there and don't let your emotions get part of it. And you know, then things will work out. But the main thing is just be consistent the way you prepare, the way we manage, the way we go after it. And there's not, you know, winning is great, but going out and executing and making sure we do the execution properly, then it'll take care of itself. Winning will.
Thanks for your time, Mr. Haley.